Hey everyone, today we're going to talk about APIs. Now you may have heard of xAPI inside of this industry. What is the API part of it? We'll talk about that and talk about a tool that will help you connect APIs together. My name is Jeff Batt, and if you haven't checked out my website already, go ahead and check out my website at learningdojo.ninja. Here you can check out all previous blog posts covering everything learning development related. You can also download templates, Articulate Storyline 360 templates, xAPI and video templates as well. And if any of these topics are new to you, you can check out courses covering everything from A to Z in Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, xAPI Fundamentals, Camtasia, Articulate Rise, Custom Scorm, and HTML5 video. So we're going to be talking a little bit about APIs. Now, this is just going to be a high-level overview of APIs, and I'm going to talk about a couple different tools that make it a whole lot easier to work with APIs. And one of the benefits of working with APIs is being able to automate different things and to connect one tool to another tool. And so if you wanted to, and thinking about project management, which us as instructional designers and learning developers and everything like that, unfortunately, we deal a lot with project management. You may like project management. It's not always my favorite thing, but it's something that can be automated. Let's say, for example, if you're testing out a course and you want somebody to be able to fill out a simple form, and then that form will get added to your to-do list, maybe even create like an email, send it out to people. Those are different things that you could automate and make easier in your production, your project management workflow. To do that, you need to work with APIs. Now let's talk about what APIs in general are. API stands for Application Programming Interface. You honestly don't even need to memorize that. If you just go in and think about, oh, an API is how one tool communicates with another tool, and what it can communicate and what it can't communicate. Those are kind of the rules where a tool will establish, here's where another tool can communicate with me, and here's where I can communicate data with another tool. All right, let's go ahead and talk about that. So we have one app. This could be something like Trello. This could be something like Gmail. This could be something like Outlook or something like that. Now, what developers will do is they'll create these APIs, and that's why I think of it like a puzzle piece, because you have some things that the puzzle piece will connect with other APIs, but you also have the part where other APIs will connect with my tool as well. So it's both kind of like inputs and outputs. You have inputs that will come in from a different tool. You have outputs that will go out from your tool to another one as well. We have these two apps. Let's say again, Trello, and let's say Gmail. If I create a Trello card, I may want to prompt a Gmail automatically or a mail to go through Gmail automatically. In order for these two tools to connect, they have to have this API. That's where having an API will actually open up this workflow, and it will allow this data to go in from one app to another app, but not all data. This depends on what the API is developed from both sides of the tools. You'll have different things that will happen in one tool that then will push over to this other tool, and this other tool will do different things with that tool, depending on their API and what they set up and what they develop as well. That is the thing, is sometimes the data will flow, sometimes it will do what you want it to do, sometimes it won't, it just depends on their API. The API is the language that one app speaks and understands another app. That's how, okay, I speak in this language, so other apps will understand what I'm sending them, but I'm also going to have these apps speak in my language in order for me to understand them as well, so I know what to do with that app, basically. We have those two apps, and then the API just connects those apps. Typically, this would be handled in code, and that historically, that's really what happened, is if you wanted to automate a lot of these different things, that API from one tool to another tool, you would have to write code. They would have documentation where you'd have to go read the documentation, learn how to use that API, and so forth. And that's kind of the standard coding language. Well, luckily there are tools out there that allow us to connect these two without knowing any type of code. So I can go in and understand what's happening from this tool and know what to do with this tool and use a user interface that makes it a whole lot easier for me to understand and me to work with. Now, the tool that I will show you today is called Zapier, but there are other tools out there which I'll mention as well. Really comes down to these two different things. It comes down to the event, what happens in one tool that then triggers an action in a different tool. What's going to happen in this other tool, basically? You think about events, you think about actions with APIs. You have events that will happen and you have actions that will happen. This app has events that it's going to listen for and it has actions it can do. This app has events it's listening for and actions it can do as well. So that's really those two different things. What event is going to happen when that event happens? What action do I want to have happen in this other tool? Almost every app that you're working with has an API. That's kind of a standard. You're working with Salesforce, you're working with Asana, you're working with Monday.com, things like that. All of them have APIs. Vimeo, YouTube, Twitter, all of them have APIs that you can work with. So you can connect these two different things. Other API connectors. I mentioned already Zapier. So there is Zapier that allows you to do this. Some of them have free levels and some of them have paid levels, just depending on what you're wanting to do. Most of them will have a free one where you can start playing around with it. You can start testing it out, making sure it's going to work for you. And then if you go beyond those different limits, then that's when you have to start paying. Now, Zapier, I know, is like $20 a month if you commit for 1 year, or it's like $35 if you're doing month to month. So it's not incredibly expensive there. But there's also things like IFTTT that will do this same type of thing. Pipe Dream as well, but you can also do things inside of Mac OS or iOS using something called Shortcuts. Or even on Android, you can use IFTTT, and there's an app there that you can create these types of connections, or there is something called Automate as well. I have been honestly obsessed with these different types of tools to be able to automate things that happen and kind of common tasks that I do in order to speed things up. These tools will help you make those different types of connections. Let's go ahead and just explore a little bit. I'm going to go into my Zapier account. And you can see that I have a couple different things here. So I have this bug submission that when somebody fills out a form, it's going to go ahead and submit that bug. Or I have when somebody fills out a Google Doc, it's going to go ahead and submit something to Asana. Let's go into that one real quick. And if you come into it, notice how here is the trigger and here is the action. We come into the trigger, and then when we come into the trigger, this is the tool that we're going to go ahead and use, which I chose Google Docs, but you can choose whatever you want. You can use Trello or whatever. Now, depending on the API of the tool that you choose, it will give me different triggers. In this case, I choose a spreadsheet. So I'm going to hit continue, and then I get some sample data that I'm going to work with. But if I choose something else, like if I go back into here and start this over, I could have that spreadsheet be like when it gets updated or when a new column gets added or a new tab gets added. Those are the different types of events that happen. And then based on what happens, you can grab some data from what happened and then you can pass it on to the other tool. I'm grabbing when somebody enters in this data from this Google Doc and I am creating a task. That's the action that I'm doing inside of Asana. So it makes it simple here. I'm just basically going through this form and filling out this form in order for this action to happen here. And then I go in, I connect my account, and this is what's called a key. In order to authenticate then work with this API, I have to log into my account. Now, Zapier has no knowledge of what your login is. It's really just looking for, it's pinging, let's say, Asana here, and it's saying, is this person okay to send over things? And they're going to say, yes, it is. It doesn't pass over login information. It doesn't do anything like that. So now we're going to come into our action, and the action is going to create a specific task inside of this project right here. And then I can start to pull information. If I click in here, I can start to pull in information from the event. So the event in this case somebody filled out a Google Doc or a spreadsheet there, and I can pull whatever they filled out to create that task. You can see here, I can do the task description. I could do the road number. I can do the task name, and task description and task name are things that I put inside of the Google Doc. So whatever you labeled inside of the Google Doc will get pulled inside of here. I can then combine those together. So you can see I can add normal text along with this other text for like the description. And then there's a lot more options here. Now it just depends on the API of Asana of what I could fill out, but I can use the information from the Google Doc in order to create that. Then I can come in here and just hit test. And if I hit test, then I can go into my Asana account, make sure everything is working. It's really just a matter of getting the trigger and then having the action happen. On the free account, you can connect these two. On the paid account, I can actually go beyond and have something else happen. I'm gonna go back to Zapier here and then go back to my account. And notice that this one connects a SurveyMonkey. So when somebody fills out a SurveyMonkey, it's gonna create a Trello card for me, but then it's also gonna send over an xAPI statement. xAPI is really connecting the course to the learning record store. So it's an API. So really you're connecting the events in the course to send over a statement and create a statement inside of the learning record store. So that's why I wanted to cover what an API is. That way you just have like the idea of like, okay, I'm working with APIs, but also show you the potential of saving you a whole lot of time and automating a lot of tasks to help speed up your project management or project or even course developments or something like that. I created one of my favorites is being able to go on site and snap a picture and track an issue that will then create a card for me inside of Trello. So just different things like that that make your life a whole lot easier. If you wanna check out more of my training, you can head on over to my website, learningdojo.ninja. You can check out all my previous blog posts. You can download templates and Articulate Storyline and xAPI. And you can also check out full courses covering everything from A to Z in Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, xAPI Fundamentals, Camtasia, Articulate Rise, Custom SCORM, and HTML5 video. And if you like this video, head on over to my YouTube channel, click that like button, subscribe to my channel, and hit the bell notification so you get notified of all future videos as they come out. That really helps my channel, allows me to continue to create these videos for you and to produce new content. And also, if you have questions, ask those questions below the video. I check those questions every week and I'll respond to every question there. That's all I have for today. Hopefully this was useful for you and you found some new idea that you can start implementing with APIs or Zapier or whatever tool that you may end up using. Again, that's all I have. So thanks everyone. I'll see you next time.